terribly sorry. It's a pleasure to meet you. My name is, of course, Dr. Zhou. It's so nice to have you here in the clinic. I hear that, according to Stacy, you are here to have your annual cranial nerve examination. Is this your first time here? Okay, that's fine. It's the first time for everyone, and you're in good hands, I promise. So do not worry, we are going to have some great. I'm sure everything's fine. It's really good, though, to come in once a year just to see where you are. We can, at that point, then monitor certain things that need working on. We can see if there's anything coming up, and it's all around just a pretty relaxed out time. So feel free to just relax, you know. It's going to be a completely relaxed time. We're going to be testing your taste, alright? Your sight, sense of hearing, of course. And I'm pretty sure you wanted to do smell, right? Yeah. Okay, so why don't we begin? We're going to first do sense of taste. So here, we prepare here at the clinic. We work with Hurigo Japanese bubblegum, and basically we get them to formulate specific kinds of bubblegum which are very enhanced in a sense of flavor, in a sense of clear distinguishable taste, and overall sense of smell. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be giving you samples of these gums, and based on those we would like you to essentially determine what flavored gum we have here. So you can see we have orange, apple, grape green, and grape purple, as well as rock melon. Okay, so we'll get into these in just a few moments. And basically, we would like you to tell us what you can smell, okay? Alright, so why don't we begin? So we get these specially imported by Japan, and we are in collaboration with some of the doctors over there, and we've been experimenting with new procedures for the cranial nerve exam. So I'm just going to take these samples. So, nonetheless, how are you doing? Yes. Yeah, you did decide to come in at a later time, I must say, but that is perfectly okay. Alright, so once again, before we start the taste part of the test, I'll just show you once again the kinds of flavors we're going to be testing on you. So we have, as I said, rock melon, so hopefully you've tasted rock melon and you're familiar with that taste. Next up, very tasty flavor. We then have orange, and then we have the hardest tests, grape green. We have grape purple. So essentially, you're going to be, for these two, how to distinguish them. One has a bit more of a black currant flavor to it, whilst the other is more sweeter, a bit more flavorous. So why don't we begin? I'm going to essentially open up a sample. Each sample comes with 4 different small droplets, which will look something like this. Now, of course, I'm not going to show you the colors as that might give away some ideas, but that's what you're going to be looking for. Or should I say, tasting for. So why don't we begin? I'm going to open one of these up, and I'd just like you to tell me what you can taste. So if you could close your eyes for a second. I'm going to pass this sample just to you. Okay. If you could give that a taste, chew it around for a bit. Yes, it's good. That is correct. That is apple. Very tasty. If you want, I will just get that sample back off you with this. Thank you. Okay, next flavor we will be testing. I'll just pop this open. So if you could just try this one for me. Okay, give it a bit of a taste. That is correct. It is grape. Specifically blackcurrant. Very good. I'm impressed. On to the next one. Great. Oh, here you go. Just take that. Get a bit of a taste. Yes, that is rock melon. Very good indeed. Let me just take this down. Where did I put that? Yes, we have actually used game pads for taking down notes. We find it to be very practical, and we've been able to target these. Okay. And lastly, one more flavor. We have two. I think, yes, one more flavor. Yes, of course, by elimination, that is the green grape flavor. So, your sense of taste seems to be pretty formidable. So, I think that's a big tick, so let me just take that one down. Okay, so, on to the next test. We are going to be actually doing a side for this part of the test. I'm simply just going to use our specifically spec. So for this part of the cranial nerve examination, we have a device which will examine your sense of sight. So this is our light spectrometer that we have here. And basically what this device does is it has multiple functions. Firstly, we take the spectrometer and we shine a wavelength through a cathode lamp, and basically we can have varying different degrees of light, some obviously more powerful than others. And essentially what we're going to be doing with this device is several tests for your sight, as you could probably tell. First is getting you to just follow the light, a classic test, which will highlight and detect how sensitive your sense of eyesight is. And then on top of that, we will also be getting you to identify the levels of light used. So this one tap, that's level one, okay? This is level two, and level three. So what we will do is, after our sight tracing test, we will just get you to identify what level of the wavelength we are showing, and that is a harder test. So if you can even do a few of them, your eyesight should be more than satisfactory. So why don't we begin? I want to get you to just follow the direction of the light with your eyes. Okay? Just follow direction of the light. And notice and remember this level. This is level one. Okay? So just follow the direction of the spectrometer. Okay. You're doing very well, I must say. Your eyesight and sense of focus and tracing seems to be pretty normal. And just follow the light. And here. Okay. So just to quickly show you, this is level one. This is level two. And level three. So what I'll just get you to do is, I'm going to get a light up. And I just like you to identify the wavelength. One, two, or three. Here we go. Yes, that is one. Yes, that is wavelength three. Correct. Again, wavelength one. Correct. Wavelength two. Wow. So your eyesight is definitely great. You are able to distinguish certain lights, meaning that you have overall very acute sense of sight. Okay. So next up, we're going to be going back to those gums. Instead of tasting them, I'm just going to get you to now smell them. So what I'd like you to do is just close your eyes, and I'm going to get one of the five samples, and I'm just going to waft a smell under your nose, and I'd just like you to identify the flavor of the gum. Okay, so why don't we begin again? We have apple red, rockmelon orange, orange, green grape, and black currant grape. So let me just open up one of these samples. I'm just going to whiff this under your nose, okay? Okay. Yes, you're on the right track. Correct. That is grape, black currant flavor. Okay, next one. Okay, just have a good smell of that. That is correct. That is also orange. Next, just have a good smell of that. Rock melon. And next, just have a good smell of that. So that is pretty good. Your sense of smell is also highly intact. Let's take my notes. Okay, so next, we're going to test your sense of hearing. So for this segment of the exam, I would like you to close your eyes, and we're going to play a variety of different sounds, and I'd like you to identify the sound. So before we start, I'll show you. Firstly, we'll have two coins, right? Next, we'll have a liquid aftershave. We'll also have one glass. We will also have, if I can just grab that out, 1 second, our monitor. And finally, we will also go ahead and use, where did I put that? Highly untechnical, if I do say so myself. A watch. So again, we have the aftershave, the watch, our device, the coins, and I think I haven't said the glass. So why don't we begin? Just close your eyes and just tell me what you think the sounds are. That is correct, that is the aftershave. Next up, the gamepad. Sorry, the device. And of course, next. Nice. Well done. You have successfully passed those, which is an take notes on that. Exceptionally well by these statistics. Your sense of sight is perfectly fine. Your taste is accurate and acute, as well as your sense of hearing. With these results, you should have no problems with your senses. We can in a later day do touch, but for now, these are great results. And I can go ahead and email them to you after payments are made. You can go see Stacey at the front office. And yes, other than that, you've done exceptionally well. If I can ask a few more questions before you head on out, just to note down in our records, what kind of diet that you eat? How would you say you eat? You cook more food at home, or would you go out and order takeaway? How many nights on average a week? Between what, 0 to 7? Okay, a few times, like 2 or 3. Alright. Next, refresh. Do you by any chance exercise how many times per week? Between 0 to 7 days. Okay, 3 to 4, not bad. It's actually very good. How often do you go outside? It's kind of hard to say that. Are you outside more often than usual? Between the scale of 1 to 10. 1 to 10. Okay, 7. Okay. And do you have any previous history in your family of any genetic hereditary illnesses, like whatever it may be? No? Okay. And do you smoke or drink regularly? No? Okay. Fantastic. Well, I will be able to detail that, and in a few weeks from now, we'll be able to just see how you're going. As at times, I thought you were having just a bit more trouble with that, but aside from that, it has been an absolute honor. Thank you for coming. I will hopefully see you next time, and keep in touch. See you soon.